Here, back again with another insane episode, guys. We hit another humongous jackpot. This is getting absolutely crazy. We found a freaking vacuum cleaner. What in the world is going on? This is crazy. But anyway, if you guys are new to the channel and tuning in for the first time, please go ahead and smash that subscribe button and join the Dumpster Squad for new episodes just like this every single night. We always find amazing stuff. I don't know what's going on lately, but like lately we've definitely been finding some crazy stuff. So if you missed last night's episode, I will leave a link down below. We found some awesome stuff in Burlington Coat Factory's dumpster, so definitely go check that out. And one more thing, I do not have a response from the giveaway winner quite yet, so go ahead and watch last night's video. Was it last night? Last night we announced the winner of the subscriber giveaway, so go ahead and check that out if you have not already, because you could have possibly won. And if I don't get a response here very, very soon, I'm going to be picking another winner, so I'll keep you updated on that. So anyway, guys, we have a lot of stuff to go through. As you can see, I do have a new microphone as well, so hopefully it doesn't sound horrible. It was really expensive, so I mean, I'm going to be using it regardless. So anyway, let's go ahead and jump into tonight's episode. All right, so the first box, guys, we got a little bit mixture of a couple different stores, but we're going to work away from here and go all the way around. Lots and lots of stuff to go through, but do have a couple things of Alta stuff inside of this box, so that is pretty cool. But we did find this, I don't know. Ooh, lots of loud noise. We did find this. It's supposed to be, I don't know, it says a lantern on it. I don't know if there is supposed to be a lantern inside of it. I'm not going to go into full detail of this, but it's a little, like, aluminum kind of thing. And it's kind of bent right there. I just bend that right back in shape. That's not going to be that big of a deal. But That's pretty much it. We did find those big giant candles if you guys saw the episode a few nights ago, so we might try to stick one of them inside there. That would look pretty cool, though. That's pretty much what that is. And then we also found this in the same store. This is from the Arts and Crafts store. This is, it just says Better Not Pout, and it's got all these little jingle things inside of it. There is a couple things of Alta, actually a pretty good bit of stuff. Everything inside of here is testers, so nothing too crazy, but it's a lot of this Clinique stuff. This is clarifying lotion. I mean, most of it is not like 100% full, as you can see, but we still took it regardless. This one is pretty full. This is liquid facial soap, and just a bunch of different stuff. They're all testers, as you can see, 7-day cream here. And then we found a bunch of freaking like liquid eyeliners, I believe. And these are all the same brand. These are Laura Geller. I don't know if I can grab one and get it to focus in. There you go. These are Laura Geller. And you can see there's literally a bunch of them. And that is pretty much it. There's no makeup palettes or nothing. But regardless, we still found a few things at Ulta, which is super cool because they always destroy all their stuff. So that is pretty much it for that box. Guys, we found a freaking quesadilla maker. This thing is super freaking awesome. I mean, obviously it was returned, as you can see. It's definitely been used. I don't know about how much. I haven't really opened it up and took a look at it, but freaking quesadilla maker. This thing is freaking awesome. Check that out. So like I said, it's been used, but it looks like everything is probably there and somebody just probably returned it because they didn't want it. But anyway, moving on here, guys, we found a ton of flipping coffees. These are for the Starbucks coffee maker, Verissimo or something like that, however you pronounce that. I do not have one of these, but I have found a bunch of these before and sold them on eBay. Sadly, they are, if it could focus in, sadly they are all expired, which is not a big deal. I've used expired coffees, it usually tastes perfectly fine, but I've sold a bunch of these on eBay, expired or not. People buy them and they pay good money for them, so I found a freaking ton of them. Bunch of different flavors too, if you guys could see like the front of the package. And I just found this trash can inside of their dumpster just to store all the stuff in to make it easy to transport. So that is pretty much it for there. We found this super nice looking lantern, and it's got like silvery-ish kind of design on the front, or not the front, on the top of it. Super awesome looking. Nothing really to look at on the tag. The glass is sadly broken right back there. I don't know if you guys could probably see it or not, but still freaking awesome nonetheless. Just take the glass out. Oh, there we go. There's a tag. $29.99 for that. Actually a pretty decent price, because that is a really, really nice lantern. So that's pretty much that. And guys, we found another humidifier. This one looks like it's brand freaking new. Like, everything is still in the plastic, so I don't know. I'll have to test that one out. The last one that we found, I don't know, maybe like a week ago. I think it was a week ago. That one worked perfectly fine, so I'm sure this one is going to as well. So that is freaking amazing. I did not see a price tag on that, though. And then, guys, we found a griddle. Look at this thing. 10 times more durable. This is a Oyster, and I do not even own a griddle, guys. Freaking awesome looking. Everything is still there. Looks brand spanking new. It looks like it's never even been used. And the plug is in there somewhere. I had to search for the plug because it was... There it is, right down there. I had to search for the plug because sadly it was not inside the box. But luckily I did find that. And there, actually I threw a couple more things inside of this box as well. This is a nonstick folding omelet pan. Looks freaking awesome. Seriously, looks really, really cool. That is something I'm definitely going to keep for myself. And then, guys, we found a... I don't know if you guys remember an episode, I don't know how long you've been following the channel, but we found a Dyson like handheld vacuum cleaner in the dumpster quite a while ago, actually at Target dumpster. And this is actually a replaceable, or a, not a replaceable, but this is an extra battery for it. So I took that because I didn't see the Dyson vacuum, but I did take the battery. So maybe they're throwing one out very soon, so stay tuned for that. I'll definitely keep you guys updated on that. But regardless, that battery fits my Dyson vacuum, so I took that. Those things are like seriously really expensive. And then finally, left inside that box, I found a bunch of these things for the refillable, like fill it yourself. I don't know, I can't get it out of packaging. Like, I forget what you call these. EcoFill, these kind of things you put in your own Keurig, you put your own coffee in. So that's pretty cool. They're all inside of there. We found another flipping the drone. I just took it out of the packaging so you guys can see it. It's made by Sharper Image, which is not like a crazy great brand, but this thing is awesome looking. Look at that controller. Looks freaking amazing. Like I said before, I'm not really great at flying these things. I usually crash them, but the thing is, it has a lot of like different kind of like modes and different kind of like stuff you can do with it. Even video streaming, you can do stunts. This is actually, believe it or not, this is seriously from the Arts and Crafts store of all places. And but that's pretty much it, guys. It looks like it has everything there, and looks like somebody just returned it. And then, guys, like I said before, we found a freaking vacuum cleaner. What in the world? Look at this thing. Everything works with it. We already tried it, as you guys can see. There was a little bit of dust in it from, I guess, the person who returned it, but we emptied it out, and then that was pretty much it. It works perfectly fine. It's a, as you can see right there, it's a Bissell Power Track Compact. It's actually pretty light. I mean, it's definitely, it's not like the greatest. It's not a Dyson, but still, for free, out of the dumpster, pretty cool, guys. All right, so this gigantic box right here, this is all stuffed full of Five Below stuff. There's Murphy. Murphy. Hi, buddy. Anyway, this whole box right here is stuffed full of Five Below items. But for the most part, guys, it's a lot of it is just like Christmas stuff. As you can see, like, this is instant decor, embossed foil wall art or something like that. Still pretty cool, but for the most part, everything is like Christmas stuff. I think there's a bunch of stickers you could put on your windows and decorate. But we did find a couple other items. Like, this is a... like a thing, a chalk blaster for your sidewalk. It looks like you put chalk in the front of it and you like spin it and it makes little circles on the sidewalk. That looks pretty cool. We actually did find two of them. And then we found a neon glitter and glow, some kind of like create amazing art. I don't know what that is, to be honest with you. Spin art. I don't know. Found that. And then, like I said, oh, we actually found a Scrabble twist game. I completely forgot about this. This thing is freaking awesome. It's a little dirty right there, but I don't even remember. I can't believe they sell this at Five Below, but I guess they do. I don't know. This was thrown in the dumpster, so we took it. It's never even been open. But like I said, the most part, everything inside this box is a bunch of Christmas stuff. Like, these are stickers for your, I guess, your windows or wherever you want to put them. And guys, this box goes all the way to the bottom. So I'm not going to bore you with all that stuff. You guys could pretty much see what it is, but there's probably at least 100 things of like Christmas stickers and all that good stuff inside there. So that is pretty much it for that box. The last few items that we found here, guys, this is a Snapware, I guess is what they call that, but it's like really cool container. Sadly, it is chipped right there, but we didn't really care, so we took it anyway. And like these sides, actually, no, the back of it, this snaps off, and there's another one in the front of it, and you can stack them like high as you want, but we only found like a set of two right here with the lid, which is freaking awesome, which we never find the lids and stuff. But that's pretty much what that is. You guys probably heard of it. That is super awesome to find, though. And we actually found these super, super nice. Look at the detail on these mirrors. These are so flippy nice, guys. And these were $49.97, but that was on clearance, so who knows what the regular price was. But sadly, I mean, we'll go over a couple problems with them, but first of all, we found three of them. One, two, three. So that is $150 right there. But like right here, guys, as you can see, it's chipped up, but I don't know. It's still kind of like, you can almost not even tell if you're not really paying attention, but this is, I think, is the worst one out of the bunch. I'm not gonna go through all of them, guys. I'm trying not to make these videos like they're going super long because we're finding so much stuff, but you guys can pretty much see what they are. Definitely really, really nice mirrors. And like I said, a little chipped up, but I think this is the worst one out of the bunch. But they all have like some kind of flaw. They're not all, none of them are like perfect. But anyway, that is pretty much it, guys. We seriously found so much freaking stuff once again. I don't know when this is going to end, but hopefully it never. We always find amazing stuff regardless, but this is really starting to get crazy. So that is pretty much all I have for you guys tonight. Thank you all so much for tuning in. If you enjoyed, please give me a big thumbs up. I greatly appreciate that. If you guys are new to the channel, go ahead and smash that subscribe button and join the Dumpster Squad, and I'll be back tomorrow with a new episode. We'll be right back.